What is going on, investors? Back again, time to talk about Boeing Company, ticker symbol BA. They reported earnings earlier today, so we'll jump into the numbers, and then finally we'll jump into the stock chart. This stock is selling off, and it's getting right down to a level that's kind of interesting. So $83 billion market cap. I want you to keep that on the tip of your brain as we work through these numbers. So let's jump into the numbers. Obviously, you know with Boeing, there's a lot of stuff going on. They've got their planes grounded. Obviously, the entire commercial airline business is under pressure as well. We've got a total backlog, we'll talk about this more in a minute, of $393 billion or 4,300 commercial airplanes. Again, guys, we've got an $83 billion market cap, and this company is claiming they have a $393 billion backlog in terms of orders. Now, let's jump into the third quarter. They reported this morning. Here's third quarter. Here's 9 months. We've got year over year on both sides here. So we've got $19 billion in the previous period, obviously down about 29% into the previous, into this quarter. So not good, guys. For the 9 months, we're seeing the same thing. But again, I think understanding the backdrop that we're in, people aren't flying. The airlines are under their customer, okay? The Delta Airlines, the Southwest, they're really struggling as well. And so it's the reason why you have this huge backlog is because their customers just simply cannot, they don't have the demand for these planes right now, and they quite frankly don't necessarily have the money as well. So moving down through the numbers, we've got operating cash flow here. It worsened. So we were at $2.4 billion in the previous period. Now we're at $4.8 billion. That's not good, cash flowing out of this business. We'll jump into the balance sheet and see how well capitalized Boeing is, see if they're able to survive this going forward. For the 9 months, take a look. In the previous period, we were down 226. Now we're up to $14 billion of cash flow out of the business. If for 9 months, that is certainly not good, especially when you take into account we made $14 billion in revenue, but nearly $5 billion of it flowed out of the company. That is not a good sign. Now, moving down through these numbers, they do show our cash here. We have $27 billion. That is, they show it to you here quarter over quarter because, boy, you're monitoring this really closely here. We went from 32 down to 27. So this cash flow that we showed you of 4.8 is flowing right off that top line cash number, basically dollar for dollar. And so that is something that you want to keep in mind. And then we also showed you for the 9 months, we have $14 billion flowing out. I don't necessarily think this is going to turn around anytime soon. This cash, I'm not saying it's going to run out, but boy, it is probably going to be depleted down to an area that will make some invested nervous for sure. Now, consolidated debt, we had $61 billion, 61.4, and we held flat at $61 billion. That's probably a positive because my guess is Boeing is likely going to need to do, or if they can, do some kind of more debt raise in the future. I think that would actually be a positive for the stock if they're able to secure that. Now, we've got the commercial airlines. Remember, Boeing has a couple different divisions. They have the commercial, they have jet fighters and kind of the government kind of aspect, and they have some other revenues as well, which we'll talk about here in a minute. But take a look at commercial airline deliveries. So in 2019, we had 62, and now we're all the way down 55% to 28. And so the revenues obviously went down huge. So obviously, basically dollar for dollar is there as well. And we're down, from 300, airline deliveries, airplane deliveries in 2019, down to 98 for the last 9 months. So we've held steady here, right about, you could call that almost one plane a day, basically for the last 9 months. Now they do note, again, I showed you this in the previous, that they have 4,300 airplanes in a backlog. Okay. They're expecting these planes to be sold. 4,300. Notice for 9 months, even in a relatively decent 9 months, they did 300. So they have 4,300 valued at $300 billion. When those planes are able to be delivered, when it happens, is anybody's guess, but guys, this is a tremendous backlog, especially when you take an account. This is an $83 billion market cap, and they have $300 billion worth of backlog business. Now, defense, safety, and security, defense, space, and security, that's better. Now, this is an interesting business. I talked about this on my last video with Boeing. So we have the third quarter here. Down just slightly in the defense sector. We went from $7 billion down to $6.8 billion. We've got operating margins relatively steady, down just slightly. And we've got earnings down just a little bit, probably a little bit more than you would want. But for the 9 months, everything's looking okay. Earnings from operations down a little bit here. We went from 20 to 19. Let's annualize this out. Let's give Boeing credit for another, call it $6 billion in the next quarter. So we'll have, I guess that's about $25 billion. $25 billion for a full year. Remember, I'm annualizing this out. This is 9 months, and we're giving them credit for another quarter that's similar to this third quarter. So they'll be at $25 billion. Okay, this is just the defense, space, and security. $25 billion in revenue, $83 billion market cap. So it gives you an idea that this company, even just their defense sector, is not that wildly, overvalued. If it was Boeing just made defensive airplanes, okay? I don't know if they probably wouldn't have an $83 billion market cap, but it probably wouldn't be that much lower. So you're almost getting a free call option, in my opinion, on these 4,300 planes and $300 billion worth of backlog planes. Now, what's interesting is in the defense, space, and security, you have a $62 billion backlog, which is, of which 30% represents orders from customers outside of the United States. So you've got a $62 billion backlog in defense. You've got a $313 billion backlog in the commercial airline business. Guys, it's not that bad. If things can turn around, I'm not necessarily saying they will or they can or it will happen anytime soon, but it's not that bad. And then finally, we've got global services as well. This is the other large business. They have some other capital things as well, but it's such small numbers. Take a look. We were down 21%. We went from 4.6 down to 3.7. But for the 9 months, not bad. Okay. Unfortunately, this kind of business is not earning a lot of money. We earned $2 billion back in the previous 9 months. And obviously there's some effects here. We're down to 307. Our margins have been cut in half. So that's a problem. Hopefully they're able to turn that around. They say that their margins decreased because of additional severance costs. So it would assume that's not necessarily a one-time thing, but it's something that probably won't reoccur year after year. And so the margins will likely come back in this business. So let's take a look. For 9 months, let's give them credit for $15 billion. We'll add this $3 billion into here so we get a 12-month number. So we've got $15 billion here. Remember, we gave them a $25 billion credit here. That's $40 billion just in defense and global services, and we've got an $80 billion market cap. So you're basically paying 2x sales just for global services and defense and security. Guys, that is basically, valuing this commercial airline business very, very, very low multiple. So this is why I do get excited about Boeing. But when we jump into the stock chart, I'll tell you some caveats here. So here we are with the stock. It's sold off today, like a lot of stocks, but they announced earnings. They weren't great. They announced some more layoffs, which is not great for the people being laid off, but probably good for the company from a financial perspective. We're up fractionally in the after hours as well with this one. So here we are. We're right on a trend line. Take a look at this. I don't mind you inching in. If you want to inch into Boeing anywhere in this 145 to even where it's at, about 150, not necessarily the worst spot, but here's my advice with Boeing. Okay, things could get worse before they get better with Boeing. And if things get worse with Boeing, we're going to break this trend line and we're going to come back down here and potentially retest the 120 mark. And if things get really bad, we could easily go south of $100 on this stock. And so that would be an incredible loss on $150 worth of shares. So I would inch into this. If you only have, say, $200, I would use fractional shares of Boeing if you cannot afford a full share. Now, say you have $1,000 that you can invest into Boeing stock, then I would inch into it one share at a time. Even if I had $1,000, I might do half of a share or three quarters of a share if you're able to do that in the brokerage platform that you have. Because here's the thing. Things could get worse in this commercial airline division, okay? The 77X, it is going through testing. Things look okay right now, but this plane has been grounded for nearly a year now. And heaven forbid if anything bad happens during those test programs or when it comes back online, this stock would bottom out so fast, it would make your head spin. So I would be very careful inching into Boeing, but I would buy it on these lower end of this range. So, because eventually this company is going to be able to come back. It will be, I believe, a success story of the vaccine, of the market coming back in general. They have these big backlogs of planes. And then I think once the election is over, eventually Washington, it doesn't matter, I think, who gets elected or what's the split between the Senate and the House. I think at some point next year, the two sides come together, or maybe just one party passes some relief for the airlines, because I think it has some bipartisan support. And I think by January, February, March of next year, when the new session of Congress comes in, they're going to be more willing and more able to do these types of things without having, like an election kind of clouding their judgment on the things that they need to do. So I think the airline sector is going to get more bailouts that will benefit Boeing, because the Southwest, the Delta Airlines, the American Airlines, that's going to give them the financial security to potentially dive into this backlog of business. But I think you're getting Boeing at a very nice valuation. But again, I want to stress that I would inch into this stock depending on the size of portfolio, depending on the size of allocation that you want in Boeing. I would inch into this one as slowly as possible. And don't worry, if Boeing stock reverses and the news gets better, the 77 Max gets approved in the first 2-3 months, it's flying colors, so to speak, and the stock chart's moving up. Don't think that you missed that. Just take it as a security blanket. Now things have started to improve. Maybe Delta Airlines buy some more planes, or Southwest buy some more planes. The stock goes up even more. I would take that as, a level of security that now I could buy even more and be a little tiptoe into this stock a little bit less, because that is what's happening with a Boeing stock. We'll be back again with more stocks here very soon. Good luck with your investments.